it looked like at one point in the game you were kind of getting an earful from Coach Saban. When he gets hot like that, like, do you have a strategy for kind of getting through it? Like, moving, like, are you trying to have a conversation with him when he's like that? Do you just say nothing, or how do you handle it?
Nah, obviously, you got to ask questions because you got to see what he wants so you can make the adjustment on the field. So when he came to me, I actually was jogging off the field. I'm like, dang, boy, he looked mad. Boy, he finna give it to somebody. And then I'm like, oh, it's me. So, like, when he was saying that, I mean, he was telling me to time up the blitz on the motion. And I know y'all seen, like, how many times do I have to tell you? You know the word. But, like, when he said that, it was kind of like one of those things that you just have to not hear how he's saying it, but you have to hear what he's saying. And, I mean, it's another thing when you look at it as far as never knowing when the camera's on you and being coachable. And I feel like the relationship that I have with him, he knows that I can take coaching like that. And it's hard coaching. And when you choose to come here, you never know when he could chew you out. And like people always say, you should be worried when he's not saying something.
Terry, on a year ago, you're standing in the end zone, last play of the game, and they throw your way, and it's incomplete, and you win the game. Take me through that scenario last year.
That scenario last year, Pete Golden called the timeout, changed the play. Coach Saban said, we playing man-to-man. Obviously, you come to Alabama to play in games like this, moments like that, and I was able to go out there, execute, and make a play. I mean, the moment was surreal. Everybody celebrated, and it's one of those things that I feel like it goes down in Alabama's history as a positive note.
It hasn't necessarily been working for other teams, but they've been targeting you a lot. Do you welcome that? Do you kind of like that to prove them wrong, or what is your feeling on that?
I mean, I just go out there, and I feel like I do the best thing I can do for my teammate. Like Coach Saban said, play the right technique, put myself in a position to make the play. And obviously, when I go out there, my mindset is try your luck.
You went against Evan Stewart and these receivers last year. Just what have you seen from him and his growth, and what stands out about that group as a whole?
Their whole receiving core is an explosive receiving core. Obviously, they have a great offensive coordinator, great coach, Jimbo Fisher, can really dial it up. And when you go against guys like that, you really have to be patient because they have, at any moment in time, the ability to take the top off. So when you go against guys like that, it really gets you excited. And, I mean, it's another test for our defense and our secondary to show why we're one of the best in the country.
Yeah, two if I can. First off, you played with Will Anderson, you played with Dallas Turner. What are similarities in their games? What are differences? And the second question, what's the most impressive thing you've seen Dallas Turner do?
Number one, the most impressive thing I've seen Dallas do is lead. Like, he's really grown, and he's changed his game as far as, I would say, on a positive note, just going out there and really trying to be a perfectionist. The guy stays after practice, runs. The guy, when it's hostility on the sidelines, he gets it kind of settled out, and he does a great job of talking to people. Most times when people go out there and try to lead, they just try to go out there and say, hey, we need to get quiet or do this. Nah, Dallas goes to the younger guys and he tells them what they need to do. And he does a really, really great job of it. And I would say as far as him and Will's game, I mean, it's Will Anderson. Like, it ain't really much you can say. The dude just blocked the field goal last week. He's a playmaker. And I would say Dallas is the same thing. But they both have a motor and they really, really love football.
Nia Smith early in the week said this game was very personal to him due to Coach Saban's and their family relationship. Obviously, that's going to be one of the receivers that you are matched up against, and he's been successful in the past against Alabama. What's your opinion on his comments and really the matchup with Nia Smith?
I seen something that said he knows what Coach Saban wants. And when I seen that, I was kind of like, what does Coach Saban want? Like, I mean, I've been here 3 years, and I don't know what the guy wants. So, I mean, I don't really know. Like, if we're being honest, I don't even really know.
Hey, Terrion, I think through five games, y'all have one less interception than y'all had all of last season. What do you think has kind of led to the defense getting more interceptions in the early part of the season so far?
It started last year with us preaching takeaways. T-Rod, when we go into practice, just emphasizing us the ball, the ball, the ball. So when we go in there, Coach Saban, you can see videos of him saying the ball's on the ground. Nobody picked it up, even when it's a dead ball. So just us on the jugs after practice as DBs and really going out there and focusing on getting the ball. Malachi, Kool-Aid, we do a great job of preaching that to the secondary, and I would say we've done a really great job of emphasizing the ball, the ball, the ball.
ESPN broadcast on the last game, the announcers in the booth said that you told them that you talked to receivers all game long. I'm curious, one, what do you say, and two, why?
That's something I kind of been doing ever since I was younger. I would say most people, when you see somebody's head bobbling or you see two guys talking, you might think they're talking trash. But, I mean, a lot of times, I just be out there having conversations. So, like, I know when y'all see this game, me and Evan, we have a great relationship. When he came down here to Alabama, I actually thought he was going to come here. Great guy. So, when you see me guarding him, I mean, you'll see me talking to him, telling him, like, hey, I'm a man-to-man this rep. You got to win. Or, I mean, he could be like, hey, I'm coming. I got this type of route. And he's that type of guy, too. And I would say, like, when I line up, it's just kind of like friendly competition and something to keep yourself motivated during the game.
Yeah, Terrion, tell us a little bit about your relationship with Kool-Aid and anything you might have learned from him.
Kool-Aid and I, we came in here together. We've been brothers right off the bat, very personable person, the type of person that will give you the shirt off his back. And I would say we've learned a lot from each other. One thing that I've taken away from him is how much he cares. The guy loves football, really puts a lot of time into it, and he's really, really smart. Like most people, like y'all see the change, see the glitz, see the glamour, but the guy really, really loves football and really cares. And I mean, being able to go out there and call him my teammate, call him my brother, and build a relationship with him is something that means a lot to me. Like I would say, we have a true brotherhood, and it's somebody that I will deal with and have a lifelong relationship with.
You mentioned that friendly competition. So, like, when there is a situation like Anais Smith or just any kind of trash talk, do you take that kind of personally, or do you kind of embrace that? Is that fun? Like, what's your mindset to situations like that? Maybe not just particularly that one, but in general.
If you had another reporter and you felt like he was asking you certain type of questions or trying to get a reaction out of somebody else and he was coming at you, like, how would you take that? So if I'm in the game and he's saying that he knows what my coach wants, I mean, obviously when I go out there, I'm going to be like, you know what Coach Saban wants, huh? Dang, what he want? Like, I mean, just little things like that. I mean, he plays in the slot primarily. Malachi goes out there, gets a PBU on him. You walk beside him, like, you know what he want. So just little things like that, things trying to get into somebody's head. And, I mean, obviously you see what type of competitor somebody is. If they shut down, then you know they can't play 60 minutes of football, and that's the type of person they are. But if they keep going, it really gets you going, and it makes the game entertaining for the crowd, makes it entertaining for you. And, I mean, you have a chance to really go out there and just put on the show.
Credit to them. They look like they lost a little bit of weight, so I think that's helping them in the pass rush also. You know, just really powerful people who move really well.
Darian, how was the communication on Saturday at Mississippi State? And then obviously it's going to be a big step up against Texas A&M. So how do you expect that to go, and how will you all prepare for that?
Yeah, SEC road game. You know, it's always going to be loud. You know, what goes into it, you just got to prepare. You know, nonverbal communication is a big thing up front, so that's something we're going to be working on all week in preparation.
Their defense kind of struggled, especially early on in the season, especially against Miami. Looking at the film of their games, have you seen it sort of gel together as the season's gone?
Yeah, you know, they're really talented defense. You know, everybody has their struggles, you know, in the beginning of the year. They kind of work through that. But, you know, they're a really good defense, and it's going to be a great challenge for us.
As someone who's manned the center position before, what kind of advice do you give to Seth to kind of just shake off the mental aspect of the snap issues?
Yeah, you know, playing center is hard. You know, there's a lot of mental things that go into it. There's a lot of other things that go into it, you know, pre-snap, and then snapping the ball is hard. You know, people think it may be easy sometimes, but when you have somebody that's 320 pounds lined up in front of you, you know, it makes it a little bit challenging. But we have all the confidence in Seth. We know he's going to get it right.
Going back to communication, how do you think Jalen did just on the road, being able to relay the calls to you guys and handling that crowd noise?
Yeah, I think he did really good. First SEC game, you know, away game. It's something you got to work on throughout the week, but, you know, we're really proud of the way he stepped up. Was very vocal, nonverbal, verbal communication, stuff like that.
Anything else? Coach Saban said yesterday that they were going to challenge y'all at practice this week because this is going to be a challenging game. So just how was practice yesterday, and how did the team kind of respond to that?
Yeah, I think his main message was if you can't take the coaching, you know, the hard coaching, how are you going to be able to perform in the game? You know, I think every competitor takes on tough coaching. It's like it's part of the game. So throughout the week, you know, we're prepared to be coached hard. You know, and that all will work out when it makes the game easier.
Kurt? Darian, I think on the depth chart that we get in the press box, you're still listed as the second center. Do you work at center in practice every day or –
I get reps at center sometimes just to make sure that I'm, you know, still sharper on that. But other than that, you know, it's just regular rotation, you know, work out a guard, and whatever they told me to do, I end up doing.
Hey, Darian. Saturday night, Coach Saban got on to you guys. And how does that affect the overall energy of the team? Because from our perspective and from fans' perspective, they were kind of waiting for Coach Saban to get fired up and did that on national TV. Does that really play a role into getting you guys kind of that energy steered towards a different direction?
I think a main message for him since I've been here is always, if you're a competitor, you don't need external motivation, you need internal motivation. And, you know, it always helps to have, you know, somebody like Coach Saban to get on you. But I think that, you know, as an offense, we knew we needed to get it going. You know, you don't want slow starts. But if it helped, you know, him getting on us and getting us going, it helped. But, you know, I think as an offense, we kind of internally knew, like, it was time to, you know, get stuff going.
Coach Saban said that the left tackles probably played their best game this year. Just what did you see from Cade and Elijah both?
Yeah, they're both really young, but, you know, every week you see them get better. Really proud of them, you know, putting their work hat on during the week and, you know, working on stuff they need to work on. Really proud of them both for going out there and, like you said, playing their best game so far.
Anything else? Thanks,
Barry. Appreciate you.
Jason, just talk us through the experience playing the first SEC road game this past weekend, and then obviously a bigger road test this weekend in Texas.
It was a great experience, you know, just to feel the environment of a different team, you know, that's trying to distraction for you, you know, a challenge to block that out and just focus on what you came to do. So that was a challenge for us. I feel like we held it well and did a great job with that.
Yeah, hey, Jace. That was obviously Jalen's first road start, not his first road game, but first road start. How do you think he handled the noise, and how do you think that maybe helped him going into this week?
I feel like it got him prepped for, you know, next week. You know, the 12th man being in Texas A&M, that's a bigger environment. I feel like it's going to be a bigger challenge. But I feel like he handled it well. You know, he came out and played great. I think it was good for him.
Austin? Yeah, just walk me through that touchdown celebration that you had there last game.
Oh, no, I got that from TikTok. I seen, like, when their quarterback scored, he did a little TikTok dance, so I said, might as well do mine. It was already in my idea, so that's what I did.
What's the secret to breaking tackles?
Secret to breaking tackles, I get that shout-out to Coach Blue and them, you know, getting me strong, you know, just having, like, a will and not going down. That's what I feel like.
I know you play a completely different position, which this may not be easy for you, but Terrion talks about talking to the opposing players. Now, he's right face-to-face with them. Do you ever talk to other players, opposing players?
I feel like that's something I try not to do because I feel like I try to put my emotion into the game. But if somebody talks to me, I feel like, yeah, I'm going to talk back. So, real. Depending on what they say.
Hey, Jace, yesterday Coach Saban, when he talked to us, said that they were going to challenge you all a little bit at practice this week because of the challenge you all have ahead. So just how was that yesterday in the first day of practice, and how do you think the team responded?
It was a lot more, you know, getting on the people. So he said that's going to be the thing he's doing. So a lot more, if you make a mistake, a lot more yelling. So trying to get that out of the way.
We talked to you during the Texas week, and you mentioned that you had a lot of family with Texas ties. Do you have a lot of any family with Texas A&M ties?
Unfortunately, I don't, but you know, support them. But that was just Texas. They like Texas.
Tell us about your most memorable butt chewing from Coach Saban.
Most memorable? What'd you say?
Butt chewing from Coach Saban.
I think it was about my freshman year when I got here. I was doing kickoff return, and I misjudged the ball and dropped it, and he told me to kiss it something. So that was one of my favorite things he said.
Awesome. Thanks, Jason.
All right.
Hey, did you like ice cream?
Ice cream.
Yep.
Yeah.
What's your favorite flavor?